And there may be another way to help people fight off the coronavirus. Using the blood of COVID survivors themselves.
Hello.
Hey, Elizabeth, looks like you're on the mend.
Yeah, I've been recovered now for...
People like Elizabeth Schneider. She was getting ready to become the first person in Seattle to donate her plasma to researchers trying to see what natural resistance she might have developed and whether she can share it.
Scientists don't know how long we have that immunity for this particular virus, but signs so far look like, you know, we will have immunity.
Survivor's blood as therapy. It's not a new idea. Doctors used it in 1918 in the midst of the Spanish flu pandemic.
I do feel a little more sense of security, you know, going out and doing my day-to-day tasks because I've already had this.
She was among the first documented COVID-19 cases in the U.S. A microbiologist who works for a biotech company, she came down with flu symptoms on February 25th, 3 days after attending a party. On Facebook, she learned many of her friends who were there were also sick, 15 in all. She told me she and seven others ultimately tested positive for COVID-19, which brought her to this moment on this morning to the blood bank in downtown Seattle.
Hi, I am here for plasma donation.
The coronavirus antibodies in her plasma may be a way for others to fend off the virus. It's called convalescent plasma therapy.
Our goal is to get the 840 milliliters today.
I'm hoping that some of my plasma ends up in another patient who is suffering from COVID-19, and this could potentially save their life.